Hello students, in the last lecture we have seen one way to track the user's data while interacting with the website. In this lecture, we will see another way of tracking the user's data with the help of session. So first, let us understand what is meant by session. A session is a way to store the information to be used across multiple pages. Like the cookie, the information is not stored on the user's computer. Now, for example, when we work with an application on a computer, like we open the application, do some changes, then we close it. So this is much like a session, because our computer knows who you are. Our computer knows who is the user. It knows when you start the application, when and when you end your application. But on the internet, there is one problem. The web server does not know who you are and what you do, because the HTTP address doesn't maintain the state that we have already discussed while we have seen working with cookies. Now this session variable solves this problem by storing the user information that is to be used across the multiple web pages. For example, like username, then the session ID, etc. By default, the session variable lasts until the user closes his or her browser. That is, in short, or in other words, we can say a session is like a cookie which provides a way to track the user's data over a series of web pages. The difference between the two is that a cookie stores the data on the client side, whereas the session data is stored on the server side. There are certain benefits of using the session. That sessions are generally more secure because the data is not being transmitted back and forth between the server and the client repeatedly. This is the first advantage. This is the first benefit, that the data is not being transmitted back and forth between the client and the server repeatedly. Then the second benefit is session lets you to store the more information than you can with the help of cookie. With the help of cookie, we can store only minimal amount of information, whereas if we use the session, we can store more information. The third benefit is that the session can be made to work even if the user doesn't access the cookie in their browser. Even if the user doesn't access the cookie, still the sessions can be made to work. When we start a session, PHP generates a random session ID. PHP generates a random session ID that is a reference to that particular session and the data that is stored in that session. By default, this session ID is sent to the web browser in the form of cookie, so that the subsequent PHP pages will use this cookie to retrieve the session ID and access the session information. Now there is an obvious question comes to mind. What to choose, which one to choose between session and cookie? As we know, the sessions have many benefits over the cookie, but there are still many reasons why we should use the cookies over session. Because the cookies have the following advantages over the session. The first advantage is that the cookies are easier to create and retrieve. Cookies are somewhat easier to create and retrieve. it requires a slightly less work from the server side, because as the cookies are stored on the client side in the web browser, so it requires the less work from the server. Then cookies normally persist over a longer period of time as compared to the session. So then, by knowing the advantages of session and cookies, now the question is which one to choose. So as a rule of thumb, we can say that we should use the cookies in situation where the security is of less important and we want to store a minimum amount of data. That is, whenever we want to store the minimum amount of data and the security is of least important for us, in such cases or in such scenarios, we have to use the cookies. Whereas if security is the main concern and there will be a lot of information to remember, then our best choice will be session. So now let us see how to create a session. Now this creating the session or creating, accessing or deleting the session, all these three operations with a session begins with a single function, that is session underscore start function. This function will send a cookie the first time a session is started. Whenever the session is started for the first time, the session underscore start function will send the cookie to the client, and therefore it must be called before any HTML is being sent to the web browser. Therefore, on the pages that use the session, we should call the session underscore start function as the very first line in our script. So whenever we deal with a session, so the session underscore start function has to be the first line in our script. So what exactly happens when we create a session? So the first time when the session is started, a random session ID is generated and a cookie is sent to the web browser with the name of the session, that is PHP session ID, and a value, some random value like the mentioned on the screen. Now once this session has been started, we can record the data to it by assigning the values to the dollar underscore session ID. We can assign the values to the dollar underscore session array as like our dollar underscore post and dollar underscore get add. So the syntax for assigning the values to the session variable, that is dollar underscore session, and we are assigning the value of mark to the first session variable, that is first underscore name. We are assigning the value of 35 to the second session variable, that is age. Each time we do this, PHP writes this data to a temporary file which is being stored on the server. We can also change the name of the session by using the session underscore name function. And because we are changing the name of the session by using the session underscore name function, it must be called before every session underscore start function. Like first you have to call session underscore name and in bracket the name of your choice. Then the second statement will be session underscore start function. So in this lecture we have seen how to deal with the session, what is meant by session, and how to create a session and how to assign the values to the session variable. In the next lecture, we will see how to access the session variable and how to delete the session.